Assalamu alaikum, students. As we discussed about the tenure of Benazir Bhutto in our last lecture, how she came in power, what kind of problems she faced during her regime, and how her government was dissolved by President Farooq Laghari. And after elections, Mr. Mia Muhammad Nawaz Sharif, the chairman of Muslim League Noon Group, came into power, and let's see what he did in his tenure and in today's lecture. Nawaz Sharif, Mia Muhammad Nawaz Sharif, was born on 25th December 1949 and is a Pakistani businessman and a politician who served as a Prime Minister of Pakistan for three non-consecutive terms in 1993, then 1997 to 1998, and then after the last tenure was 2013 to 2017. Sharif is the longest serving Prime Minister of Pakistan, having served a total of more than 9 years. And born into the upper middle class Sharif family in Lahore, Sharif was a son of the founder of Ittefaq and Sharif Group. And he is the elder brother of Shehbaz Sharif, who also served as the Chief Minister of Punjab. And before entering politics in the 1970s, Sharif studies business at Garmin College and law at the University of Punjab. He was not too much interested in politics, but by chance he can get the idea to enter into politics. Although he did his LLB from the Punjab University and joined his influential business in its Ittefaq group, but that was interested in sugar, steel, and textile mills. But with passage of time, he indulged in politics. And Sharif suffered financial loss when his family steel business was appropriated under the nationalism policies of former Chief Minister Zulfikar Ali Bhutto. And according to the personal accounts and his time spent with Sharif, American historian Stephen Phillips Cohen states in his book Idea of Pakistan, Nawaz Sharif never forgave Bhutto after his steel empire was lost. Even after Bhutto's terrible end, Sharif publicly refused to forgive the soul of the Bhutto or the Pakistan's People's Party. Sharif entered politics as a result, initially focused on regaining control of steel plants. In 1976, Sharif joined the Pakistan's Muslim League and the conservative front rooted in Punjab province. And in May 1980, Ghulam Jilani Khan, the recently appointed military government of the Punjab province and a former director general of the Inter-Service Intelligence (ICI) was seeking new urban leader. He quickly promoted Sharif, making him finance minister. During the 1980s, Sharif gained influence as a supporter of General Muhammad Ziaul-Huq military government. Ziaul-Huq agreed to return the steel industries to Sharif, who convinced the general to denationalize industries to improve the economy. And within Punjab, Sharif privatized government on industries and presented development oriented budget to the military government. And Punjab was the richest province and received more federally funding than the other provinces of Pakistan and contributed to inequality at economic level. Soon he came into power after the elections and became the nominated chief minister of Punjab against the prime minister wishes of Prime Minister Muhammad Khan Junejo. And within the backing of the army, Sharif secured a land victory in the 1985 elections Because of his popularity, he received the nickname Lion of the Punjab. Sharif built ties with the senior army generals who sponsored his government. He maintained an alliance with the general Rahimuddin Khan, chairman in the Joint Chief of Staff Committee. Sharif also had close ties with the Lieutenant General retired Hamid Gul, the director of ISI. As well as a chief minister, she stressed welfare and development activities and the maintenance of law and order. Khan beautified Lahore, extended military infrastructure and silenced political opposition, while Sharif expanded economic infrastructure to benefit the army in his own business interest and the people of the Punjab. In 1988, General Zia-ul-Haq dismissed the government of Janejo and called for a new elections. However, Zia retained Sharif as the chief minister of Punjab province, and until his death, he continued to after the death of General Zia-ul-Haq Khan in August 1988, Zia-ul-Haq political party, Pakistan Muslim League, Pagada group split into two factions. Sharif led the Zia-ul-Haq loyalist Fida group against the Prime Minister Janejo group. And after that, the Fida group later took on the mantle of the Prime Minister PMLN, while the Janejo group became known as the GIP. The two parties, along with seven other right-wing conservative and religious party, united with encouragement and funding from the ICI to form the Islamic Jumhuria-e-Ittehad, IGI. The IGI received almost 15 million rupees from Zia loyalist in the ICI, ISI, with a substantial role played by Sharif allies. And the alliance was led by Sharif and Ghulam Mustafa Jatoi and opposed Benazir Bhutto, Pakistan's People's Party, in the elections. This was a great scenario when both parties are against each other and want to win the elections. Despite Benazir being successful in forming government, the IGI gained substantial majority in the Punjab and Sharif was re-elected as a chief minister of In 19 December 1989, Sharif decided to remain in the provisional Punjab Assembly rather than hold a seat in the National Assembly. In early 1988, the People's Party government attempted to unseat Sharif through a vote of no confidence motion in the Punjab Assembly, which they lost by 152-106. The conservative force came to the power in democratic Pakistan under the Sharif leadership. Nawaz Sharif became the 12th Prime Minister of Pakistan on 1st November 1990, succeeding Bhutto. He also became head of IGI. Sharif had a majority in the assembly and ruled with considerable confidence and authority. Sharif had campaigned on a conservative platform and vote to reduce government corruption. Nawaz Sharif introduced an economy based on privatization and economic liberalization to reserve the nationalization by Zulfikar Ali Bhutto to reverse, and notably for banks and industry. He also legalized foreign money exchange to be transacted through private money exchanges. His privatization policies were continued by Benazir Bhutto in the mid-1990s. And Shaukat Aziz, who became the interim Prime Minister of Pakistan in 2000s. He also improved the national infrastructure and spurred the growth of digital telecommunication. Let's discuss in detail what kind of privatization policies he observed during his rule. Sharif had campaigned on conservative platform, and after assuming office, his economic public policy, the National Economic Reconstruction Program, NERP. This program introduced an extreme level of the Western-style capitalist economy. Unemployment had limited Pakistan's economic growth, and Sharif believed that not only privatization could solve this problem. Nawaz Sharif also introduced an economy based on privatization and economic liberation, notably for banks and industries. According to the United States Department of US Department of State. This followed a vision of turning Pakistan into South Korea by encouraging great private saving and investment to accelerate economic growth. During his regime, he reversed all the policies opted by Zulfikar Ali Bhutto in 1990s, and he introduced almost around 150 national industries as open for private ownership, including the National Development Finance Corporations, NDFC, Pakistan's National Shipping Corporation, National Electric Power Regulatory Authority, Pakistan International Airlines, Pakistan Telecommunication Corporation, and Pakistan State Oil. This boosted the economy, but a lack of competition in bidding allowed the rise of business oligarchy and further widened the wealth gap, contributing to political instability. And due to these privatizations, few families came in power and get the control of Pakistan's economy, almost 60% of the economy, which led towards great instability as well as welfare of the servants. Sharif had campaigned on conservative platform. Let's look over industrializations during 1951 to 2009. Here is a growth chart, and you can see that in initial time period, Nawaz Sharif initiated several large private industries and projects such as Ghazi Bharota Hydro Project. However, unemployment remained a challenge in an attempt to counter this. Nawaz Sharif imported thousands of private yellow cab taxis for young Pakistani, but few of the loans were rapid and Sharif was forced to pay for them through his steel industries. Nawaz Sharif projects were not evenly distributed, focusing on Punjab and Kashmir provinces. The base of his support with lesser efforts in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa and Balochistan provinces and no benefits from industrialization in Sindh province. After intense criticisms from Pakistan's People's Party and MQM, Sharif completed the Aurangi Cottage Industrial Zone, but this did not repair his reputation in Sindh. Opponents accused Nawaz Sharif of using political influence to build factories for himself and his business, for expanding the armed forces secretariat industry. And these were the allegations which were put over Nawaz Sharif regime, and he has to face a lot of criticism. However, about Islamic policies, he just followed Ziaulak, and reforms was managed to introduce facial conservatism, supply side economics, bioconservatism, and religious. Nawaz Sharif intensified Ziaulak's controversial Islamization policy and introduced Islamic laws such as the Shariat Ordinance and Baitul Mal to help poor orphans and widows were to drive the country on the model of Islamic welfare state. Moreover, he gave tasks to the Ministry of Religion to prepare reports and recommendations for steps taken towards Islamization. He ensured the establishment of three committees: Ittihad-e-Bainul Muslimin, Nifaz-e-Shariat Committee, Islamic Welfare Committee. Sharif extended membership of economic cooperation organizations to all Central Asian Muslim countries to invite them and to unite them in a Muslim bloc. Sharif include environmentalism in his public government reform and environmental protection policies. He also tried his best to promote scientific research and expansion of science in Pakistan. While privatizing industries, he took a few good steps for control of science, government control over the science. In 1991, Muhammad Nawaz Sharif founded and authorized the Pakistan Antarctic Program under the scientific directions of National Institutions of Oceanography, NIO, with the Pakistan's Navy Weapons Engineering Divisions, and first established the Jinnah Antarctic Station and Polar Research Cell. In 1992, Pakistan became an associate member of the Scientific Committee on Antarctic Research. On 28 July 1997, Sharif declared 1997 as a year of science in Pakistan and personally allotted funds for the 22nd INC College on Theoretical Physics, as well as in 1999, Mohammad Nawaz Sharif signed the executive decree declaring 28 May as the National Science Day in as he did number of policies, introduced policies in Pakistan. He also worked over nuclear policy, and he did some remarkable work in this field as well. Mohammad Nawaz Sharif made the nuclear weapons and energy program one of his top priority and expanded the nuclear energy program and continued an automatic program while followed a policy of deliberate nuclear ambiguity. This resulted in a nuclear crisis with the United States, which tightened its embargo on Pakistan in December 1990 and reportedly offered substantial economic aid to help the country uranium enrichment program. Responding to US embargo, Sharif announced that Pakistan had no atomic bomb and would sign the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty if India did as well. However, the embargo blocked plans for a French-built nuclear power plant, so Nawaz Sharif advisors intensively lobbied the International Atomic Energy, which allowed China to establish a nuclear power plant and upgraded Kanap 1. Nawaz Sharif's nuclear policy was considered less aggressive towards India, with its focus on public usage through nuclear power and medicine, viewed as contributions of the United States Atoms for Peace program. However, in 1993, Sharif established the Institution of Nuclear Energy, INI, to promote his policy for peaceful use of nuclear. He also works for cooperative societies, which became a scandal for his government, and he has to face a lot of crisis from his opponent political parties. However, mismanagement led to collapse or affecting millions of Pakistani in 1992, especially in Punjab and Kashmir. Around 70,000 people lost their savings, and it was discovered that the billion of rupees has been granted to Ittefaq Group of Industry, Sharif Steel Mill. Although the loans were hurriedly repaid, Sharif's reputation was severely damaged, and it was a great and especially for his political career. Constitutional crisis began, and on April 18th, ahead of the 1993 parliament elections, Khan used his reserve power of 58-2B to Ghulam-e-Issa Khan dissolve the National Assembly, and with the support of the army, appointed Mir Balakh Sher Khan as an interim minister. Sharif refused to accept his act and raised his allegation against him in Supreme Court. However, in 1993, under pressure from the armed force, Sharif resigned under an agreement that also removed President Ghulam-e-Issa Khan from his power. Chairman of the Joint of Staff Committee, General Shamim Alam, and the Chief of Army Staff, Abdul Wahid Kakar, forced Ghulam-e-Issa Khan to resign from presidency and engaged the political standoff under the close scrutiny of Pakistan's armed forces. On interim and transitional government was formed, and new parliamentary elections were held after just 3 months of government. He became opposition leaders. Now, after the elections, Pakistan's People's Party, Benazir Bhutto government was formed, and he came into power once again while having a great deadlock between PPP and PMLN. Benazir found it difficult to act effectively in the face of opposition from Sharif, and also faced problems in her political stronghold of Sindh province from her younger brother Murtaza Bhutto. Mohammad Nawaz Sharif and Murtaza Bhutto formed the Nawaz Bhutto axis and worked to undermine Benazir Bhutto government. topping an anti-corruption wave in Pakistan. They accused the government of corruption with major state coordinations and slowing economic progress. In 1994 and 1995, they made a train march from Karachi to making critical speeches to huge crowds. Now, Mohammad Nawaz Sharif organized many strikes throughout the Pakistan in September and October 1994. And in 1996, Murtaza Bhutto was murdered in Sindh, and Benazir Bhutto came under allegation that he is in power, and during his regime, her brother has been murdered, and this was a great accused, and she became unpopular across the country. That as a second term as a prime minister, Benazir Bhutto has distorted the Pakistan's economy, which was nearing failure. And in 1997, parliamentary elections held, and Pakistan's Muslim League once again won overwhelming victory with an exclusive mandate from Pakistan. It was hoped that Sharif would deliver on promises to provide a stable conservative government and improve to overall conditions. Sharif was sworn as prime minister on 17 February. Sharif Mia Mohammad Nawaz Sharif formed an alliance with Altaf Hussain's MQM, and Sharif had removed the MQM from parliament and resumed control of Karachi while MQM was forced underground. This led Sharif to claim an exclusive mandate, and for the first time Sharif and IPMLN had the control of the Sindh, Balochistan, KPK and Kashmir and Punjab. With a supermajority, Sharif's new government amended the constitution to restrict the power of president to dismiss government with the passing of 14th amendment. Mohammad Nawaz Sharif's popularity peaked in May 1988 when he announced nuclear weapons test in response to Indian test, which when Western countries suspend foreign aid, but Sharif froze the country foreign currency reserve and economic conditions worsened. The country became embroiled in conflicts of two borders, and Sharif's long-standing relationship with the military established fell apart as they, by mid-1999, few approved his policies. As during the elections of 1997, Mohammad Nawaz Sharif promised to follow his policy of nuclear ambiguity while using nuclear energy to stimulate the economy. However, on 7 September, before a state visit to United States, Mohammad Sharif acknowledged in an STN News interview that the country he had an atomic bomb since 1978, and Mohammad Nawaz Sharif maintained the issue of atomic capability is an established fact in the debate too, since Pakistan has progressed significantly and we have to left very much stage for behind. Pakistan will not made a hostage to India by signing CTBT before India. This was the announcement given by Mohammad Nawaz Sharif 7 September 1997. On 1st December, Mohammad Nawaz Sharif told the Daily Jung and the News International that Pakistan would immediately become a party of the Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty, CTBT, if India signed it and ratified it first. Under his leadership, the nuclear program had become a vital part of the Pakistan's economy policy. However, in 1998, after May 1998, soon after the Indian nuclear test, Mohammad Nawaz Sharif swore that his country would make a suitable reply on 14th May. Leaders of the opposition, Benazir Bhutto and MQM, called for the nuclear test, followed by the calls for the public. When India tested its nuclear weapon the second time, it caused a great alarm in Pakistan and pressures mounted on Sharif families on 15th May. However, Sharif put the armed force on high alert and called a National Security Council meeting discussing the financial, diplomatic, military, strategic and national security concerns. Only Troyer, Mr. Sartaj Aziz opposed the test due to economic recessions, low foreign exchange reserves and economic sections. Mohammad Nawaz Sharif was initially hesitant of the economic impact of nuclear testing and observed the international reactions to the Indian test. where an embargo had no economic effect, failure to conduct the test would put the credibility of Iceland's nuclear deterrence in doubt, which was emphasized when India Home Minister Lal Kishan Chand Advani and Defense Minister George Fernandes lauded and belated Pakistan, angering Mohammad Nawaz Sharif. Pakistan's on 8 May, Mohammad Nawaz Sharif offered the Pakistan's Atomic Commission to prepare the test and put military forces on high alert to provide support. On 21st May, Mohammad Nawaz Sharif authorized nuclear weapon test in Balochistan. On 27th May, the day before testing, the ISI detected Israel F-16 fighters conducting exercise and received intelligence that they ordered to attack Pakistan's nuclear facility on behalf of India. Mohammad Nawaz Sharif scrambled the Pakistan's forces and had nuclear bombs prepared for deployment. According to political scientist Shafiq H. Hashmi, the US and other nations assured Sharif that Pakistan was safe. The Israel attack never materialized. Situation was very difficult. It was that पाकिस्तान की गवर्नमेंट जो है ये इसको बर्दाश्त नहीं कर पाएगी, इस प्रेशर को, और इंडिया और इसराइल मिलकर जो है पाकिस्तान के ऊपर अटैक कर देंगे. और पाकिस्तान जो था उसने 28 मई को और 30 मई को सक्सेसफुल टेस्ट चागी वन और चागी दो के पहाड़ों पर किए. और ये जो पाकिस्तान जो थे नेशनल टीवी पर जब आए और उसने ये कहा कि पाकिस्तान अगर जो है ऐसा ना करता और 15-20 साल से जो उसके पास इस रीजन के अंदर एबिलिटी थी और वो अगर इंडिया को शो ना करता तो हमें बहुत सारी रिस्ट्रिक्शंस जो थी वो देखनी पड़ सकती थी. हाँ, लेकिन हम कोशिश करेंगे कि हमारे जो बॉम्ब्स हैं वो हिरोशिमा और नागासाकी जैसे तकलीफ दे एटॉमिक बॉम्ब्स ना बने, और हम ये सब काम जो है मुल्क की मफाद के अंदर करते हुए दिखाई दें. तो ये वो एक्सप्लेनेशंस थी जो कि दी जाती रही और कोशिश की जाती रही एक सेफ जोन के अंदर. और इसके अलावा पाकिस्तान की जो इकोनॉमी पॉलिसी थी उसको रीबिल्ड करने की काफ़ी कोशिश की गई, मोटरवेज बनाई गई, और एक ऐसा बड़ा प्रोजेक्ट था, एक मेगा प्रोजेक्ट था जो कि पाकिस्तान की हिस्ट्री में पहला M2 मेगा प्रोजेक्ट था, जो कि तकरीबन यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स के 989.12 मिलियन जो पॉन्ड्स थे उसमें कंप्लीट होना था. बहुत सारा क्रिटिसिज्म्स नवाज शरीफ को इस बड़े हाईवे के ऊपर बियर करना पड़ा, और इसका जो डिस्टेंस था दो बड़े शहरों के दरमियान डिस्टेंस कम करने के अलावा ये पेशावर से कराची तक की जो एक बड़ी मोटरवे थी जो कि पंजाब को कश्मीर को लिंक करती थी सिंध से बलोचिस्तान से, तो बहुत बड़ा प्रोजेक्ट इन्वेस्टमेंट प्रोजेक्ट बनाया गया. अगरचे बहुत सारी स्टेशन जो थी वो लिफ्ट ओवर भी हुई और बहुत सारा फंड जो है पाकिस्तान ने अचीव किया और बहुत काफ़ी कर्जे भी लिए, लेकिन इकोनॉमिक प्रेशर जो था वो पाकिस्तान के नेशनल स्पेस प्रोग्राम के लिए बड़ा मुश्किल दौर रहा, और इस हवाले से कोई ज़्यादा फील्ड में तरक्की नहीं की जा सकी. और इसके अलावा बहुत सारे करप्शन के चार्जेस जो थे वो नवाज शरीफ पर आते चले गए, और ये देखा गया कि जो सेकंड टर्म थी वो इस बात पर ख़त्म होती दिखाई देती है कि डेब्ट रेट बहुत ज़्यादा भर जाता है और अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट पाकिस्तान में बहुत ज़्यादा इंक्रीज हो जाती है. पाकिस्तान के पास जो इस वक्त डेब्ट हैं वो ऑलमोस्ट 32 बिलियन डॉलर्स के हैं, जबकि इससे ज़्यादा रिजर्व सिर्फ 1 बिलियन डॉलर के थे. और बहुत सारी ऐसी डिमांड्स थी जो कि इंटरनेशनल मॉनिटरिंग फंड की तरफ जो है वो की जा रही थी. इसके अलावा जो नवाज शरीफ साहब ने इस दौर में कोशिश करनी चाहिए वो ये थी कि किसी तरह से एड्स अमेंडमेंट को कम किया जाए और वो जो पावर्स ज़ियाउलहक के पास थी वो रिड्यूस की जाए, ताकि पाकिस्तान जो है वो सेमी प्रेसिडेंशियल सिस्टम से निकल के ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा पार्लियामेंट्री सिस्टम की तरफ आ सके. लेकिन ये अमेंडमेंट जो थी 2/3 मेजॉरिटी से सेनेट में फेल हो जाती है. पीपल्स पार्टी की बहुत बड़ी इसके खिलाफ थी, और पार्लियामेंट जो है उसको लीगल फ्रेमवर्क ऑर्डर जो है उसको देखना पड़ता है जो कि सेमी प्रेसिडेंशियल सिस्टम है. नवाज शरीफ 14 अमेंडमेंट जो है वो कंसोलिडेट करने की कोशिश करते हैं और लॉ मेकिंग की तरफ जाते हुए देखते हैं, अपील करते हैं कि जजेस जो है वो उस पर वोटिंग जो है वो ना कर सकें। हाउएवर रिसेशन जो है वो दो हिस्सों में तकसीम हो जाती है और एक बड़ा क्राइसिस जो है वो वहाँ पर रेज। पाकिस्तान जो है वो 1997 के कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन क्राइसिस के अंदर दाखिल होता है, वो नज़र दिखा देता है। शरीफ को सीनियर जजेस की जो सीनियरिटी लेवल्स को आगे पीछे करने के जुर्म का भी सामना करना पड़ता है, एलिगेशन का सामना करना पड़ता है और उनके खिलाफ एक पिटीशन क्वेटा में दायर होती है। अली शाह जो है वो चाह रहे हैं कि उन्होंने ये दायर किया और उनका ये कहना है कि ये दो जजों को गैर मुनासिब तरीके से उनका रैंकिंग जो है हाई की गई है। पेशावर हाई कोर्ट जो है वो इसके हवाले से एक इशू करती है, ऑर्डर्स इशू करती है कि रिमूविंग अली शाह को जो है वो रिमूव करने का कोई इख्तियार नहीं था। इसी तरह से 30 नवंबर को हम ये देखते हैं कि क्लाश नंबर में सुप्रीम कोर्ट जो है वो के ऊपर हमला किया जाता है और बहुत सारे लोग जो हैं वो देखते हैं कि उनकी बात को नहीं फॉलोअप किया जा रहा और इस सूरत में जो प्रेसिडेंट आरोप लगा रही हैं वो रिज़ाइन करते हैं और एक्टिंग वसीम सज्जाद जो हैं उनको प्रेसिडेंट बनाया जाता है और नसीम अली शाह जो हैं वो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन क्राइसिस को ख़त्म करते हैं। ऑन 29 नवंबर 2006 को श्री मोहम्मद नवाज शरीफ जो हैं वो अपॉलोजी कहते हैं फॉर देयर एक्शंस टू नसीम अली शाह एंड लगारी और एक रिटर्न अपॉलोजी है वो जो है वो जमा कराई जाती है। कुछ उनकी तरफ से गलत हुआ, मिलिट्री के साथ जो रिलेशंस हैं नवाज शरीफ गवर्नमेंट के वो भी कोई बहुत ज़्यादा अच्छे नहीं रहे इस दौरान। और फ्रॉम 1981 to 1999 तो उन्होंने काफ़ी सारी पावर्स जो थी वो उस तरह से इंजॉय की कि उनको मिलिट्री का बहुत ज़्यादा सपोर्ट हासिल था। हाउएवर इन 19 अक्टूबर 1998 थ्री मंथ बिफोर द एंड ऑफ हिज टर्म करामत वाज फोर्स्ड टू रिज़ाइन, जनरल करामत को ज़बरदस्ती उनकी हुकूमत से अलग किया गया और मोहम्मद नवाज शरीफ ने जनरल परवेज को जनरल करामत की जगह अपॉइंट किया और इसी तरह से जॉइंट चीफ बनाया डिस्पाइट ऑफ द लेक ऑफ सीनियरिटी है। ताकि उससे पहले एडमिरल फसीह बुखारी जो थे उन्होंने रिज़ाइन कर दिया इस प्रोटेस्ट में कि नवाज शरीफ ने अगेंस्ट दी हायरार्की जाके ये काम किया है। और इन अगस्त इंडिया शूट डाउन अ पाकिस्तान नेवी रिकंस्ट्रक्शन एयरक्राफ्ट इन अटलांटिक इंसिडेंट killing 16 naval officers, the greatest numbers of combat casualties of the Navy since the Indo-Pakistan War 1971. Sharif failed to again support against India for the incident with newly appointed Chief of Naval Staff Admiral Hal Abdulaziz or viewed as a lack of support in wartime. Kafi problems fir again se uthti hain aur ye crisis jo hai maritime ka International Court of Justice mein leke jaya jata hai और हम देखते हैं कि जो रिलेशंस हैं वो मज़ीद ख़राब होते चले जा रहे हैं आर्मी के और मियां नवाज शरीफ के, और इस दरमियान में जो मुशर्रफ साहब हैं वो अपना रोल प्ले करने के लिए तैयार हैं और वो लगता है कि हुकूमत में हैं। और ये देखा गया कि ये जो कारगर वॉल्स के जो आफ्टर इफेक्ट्स थे उस पर काफ़ी ज़्यादा हुकूमत और मिलिट्री के दरमियान क्लैशेस उठे और आर्मी का ख्याल था कि बहुत ज़्यादा एलिगेशंस जो हैं ये ज़्यादा जो है ना गवर्नमेंट का काम है। शरीफ मोहम्मद नवाज शरीफ को ऑर्डर थे कि सिंध पुलिस फोर्स को कहा गया कि मुशर्रफ को गिरफ्तार कर लें, लेकिन एयरपोर्ट पे जब वो एयरपोर्ट पे से उतरे लेकिन मुशर्रफ ने पहले ही बाकायदा तौर पर प्लान बना कर हुकूमत जो है वो गिरा दी और खुद हुकूमत में आके the military placed orders on trial for kidnapping, attempting murder, hijacking and terrorism and corruption in a speedy trial against Mian Nawaz Sharif in military court and he gave him a life sentence. Mohammad Nawaz Sharif was put in the jail, but he tried to make a Mama Nawashif has great relations with Saudi Arabia, and King Fahd and enjoyed extremely close business and cultural relations. And he has sometimes attributed a special relationship. Saudi Arabia was shocked at the news of the COP, and amid pressure of the Fahd and United States President Bill Clinton, the military court awarded a residence for Mohammad Sharif under an agreement facilitated by Saudi Arabia. Sharif was placed in exile for next 10 years and agreed not to take part in politics in Pakistan for 21 years. He also fortified property worth rupees 18.3 million and $5.7 and paid the fine of $5 lakhs. Musharraf wrote in his memories that without the intervention of Fahad, Muhammad Nawashi would have been executed. And Sharif traveled to Jeddah, Saudi Arabia, where he was taken to residence managed and controlled by the Saudi government and provided a Saudi loan to establish a steel mill there. However, on 23rd August 2007, the Muhammad Nawaz Sharif and his brother Shehbaz Sharif was free to return to Pakistan. Both were to return as soon. On 8th September, Lebanese politicians Saad Hariri and Saudi intelligence chief Prince Mukarrin bin Abdulaziz had an unprecedented joint press conference at Army Commandant Headquarters to discuss how Sharif's return would affect relations. Mukarrin expressed hope that Sharif would continue with the agreement to not to return for 10 years, but these little things do not affect relations. 2 days later, Sharif returned from exile in London to Islamabad. He was prevented from leaving the airplane and he was deported to Jeddah, Saudi Arabia with an arc. Political career appeared. However, in 20th November 2007, he first time left Pakistan since implementing emergency rule. He attempted to convince Saudi Arabia to prevent Sharif from returning until after the January 2008 election. Sharif had become more politically relevant after the return to Pakistan of Benazir Bhutto, who had also been exiled. So Saudi Arabia suggests that if Pakistan had allowed a democratic socialist women leader Benazir Bhutto to return to Pakistan, then the conservative Sharif should be permitted to return as well. After an 11 processions from the airport, he reached Moscow, where he offered prayers as well as criticism against Musharraf. In elections 2008, Sharif believed that the poll would be fair, and given a state of emergency posed by Musharraf, Sharif and PMLN decided to participate in parliamentary elections, and after 33 opposition groups, Benazir sessions led to postpone the elections to February 2018. As the elections approached, the country faced four terrorists in attack by militant. Sharif accused Musharraf for ordering anti-terror operations but had left the country drowned in blood. Sharif made coalition with People's Party and under leadership of Asif Ali Zardari, but the alliance was strained by differences. Sharif won much political support, but his uncompromising stand and the coalition successfully forced Musharraf resignation from the presidency. And after the coalition's collapse, Sharif pressured Zardari to resign the judges Musharraf removed during the emergency. This led the court absorbing Sharif's criminal record so that he could be re-entered into the parliament. And they decided to have Musharraf's impeachment on 7th August 2018. As a charge sheet has been drafted and was be presented to the parliament, it includes Musharraf's first sizes of power in 1999 and his second in November in 2017. The National Assembly was summoned 4 days later to discuss impeachment proceedings. On August 18, Musharraf resigned as the President of Pakistan due to mounting political pressures. Sharif claimed that the Musharraf was responsible for the crisis in the nation. Now let's talk about the third time Nawaz Sharif passed and his tale of corruptions, how he has secured mafia, and after getting political victory in 2013, the rival Tehreek-e-Insaf party led by Imran Khan denounced the elections as rigged and held protest in Islamabad for several months. There is a number of charges which was put by PTI over PMLN, and he wants a great and clear